and modern science is catching up with, you know, with what religious people. Good.
Do you feel like the Bible explains the whole universe and how there's like so many planets? And do you feel like that makes sense to you, like reading the Bible?
Well, you know, this is something that they call it, the stars are numbered, God, you know. This is something that actually Bernie has brought up in past debates, and he calls it the God of the gaps. I say there's an atheism of the gaps too, and people shove into those gaps opinions. I have this thing that I call truth phobia, F-O-B-I-A, and I'm saying you haven't really landed on truth if it's based on feelings, opinions, beliefs, intellectualizing, or authorities. So you haven't really landed on the truth if you're relying, I mean, foolproof, if you're relying on any of those things. So that's what I try to stick with. I'm not coming saying I believe in the Bible. I don't.
If it's God's word, then why didn't he mention all these planets and just, you know, let everyone know everything that's going on? Like, why do we have
to? Because there's no need to.
Why doesn't the Bible explain so many things? Like,
because, you know why? It's because that wasn't his whole plan. His whole plan was to give men life and to bring them in to have a relationship with him. And he gave us a mind of our own to think and to observe and to create, right? And so through us being able to think freely, which he made us to think freely, you know, we observe that there's gravity. We observe that there's the stars. We observe that there's the moon, you know? And we want, and, you know, just that nature within us wanna know about these things. Now there's no proof. I mean, there's proof of it, but yeah, you know why? There ain't no neighbor next to us on the moon. There's a lot of things I want to know. I want to know. I want to know about the planets. I want to know, you know. But if we really, it's better. Okay, before we even think about the stars and the moon, let's figure us out first. Let's figure our hearts out. Let's figure our minds. Let's figure why we're here.
Bible,
before we even think about
outer space. The Bible explains people in that time period. It doesn't explain this time period.
Right.
It doesn't explain so many things. It explains that little area, well, and time period.
It doesn't explain the stories of the women.
Let me say something about evolution. I have a really good anti-evolution point. Okay, so if evolution is the natural propensity of physicality to evolve from molecules to man, why don't we see it on any other planet? See, it's only happened here, and it's happened to a great degree.
We don't know what's going on. We can see what's going on on other planets.
Oh,
we can see every planet.
In all fairness, evolution doesn't explain the origin of life. It just explains how life has changed through speciation. After life has started, we still don't know how exactly
like
started in the first place.
Right, exactly. Yeah, and that's the same with the universe, the physical universe. The first law of thermodynamics says that energy can neither be created nor destroyed. So
It's a closed system.
Yeah, right.
Okay, so I do think, talking about other planets and stuff like that, we haven't explored enough to really say much.
Well,
so it's kind of like taking, you know, this has been said plenty of times, but it's like taking a cup of water out of the ocean and saying, well, no whales exist because there are no whales that I can find in this cup. And so we don't know what has gone on in other planets.
So why make a conclusion about it?
No,
that's the God of the gaps or the evolution of the gaps.
Well, I think we can make a conclusion about evolution from what we see on this planet, from the one example of life that we truly do have.
Yeah.
But I don't think that we can, you know, extend it to the rest of the universe.
Right. Well, yeah, here's what I say about aliens and all that. If there are aliens on other planets, there still had to be a God, because the first law of thermodynamics is energy cannot be created or destroyed. So nothing physical can create something else physical, and therefore aliens are pictured as being physical things.
I still don't understand how
Jesus
you get non-physical.
Let's finish this section here. Then we'll do that. Go ahead.
I still don't understand how you get non-physical. Because, I mean, that's really...
It has to be.
The physical world is basically all that we've known and seen.
Everybody agrees with the Big Bang as being the origination of the physical universe, and because of the first law of thermodynamics, something non-physical had to start the physical universe, because physicality doesn't have the ability to do that.
Well, you need to be careful there, because scientists don't know what caused the Big Bang, if there's a multiverse or whatever. So to say it has to be this, that's basically pretending to know things you don't know. Nobody knows that.
Well, see, that's why what it comes down to is that you have to prove that the Bible is a book of truth, a perfect book of truth. And that's what I've done with my book.
Can you do that when nobody even knows who wrote it?
Yeah, I mean, there are four different gospels
that
tell different stories.
Not really. Yeah, okay.
They do tell different
stories. We'll give you an example.
Well, no, we'll go there, but first I want to just follow up on this current line of questioning. I think one thing, another aspect of this question is, when the people who originally wrote the Bible, both the Old Testament and the New Testament, they thought this, there's a geocentric universe, that everything went around the earth, and these stars in the heavens were
that's
just in the firmament.
That's not in the Bible. What you just said is not in the Bible.
That's what they believed back then.
You don't believe
some people thought back then.
You thought there were people that were not geocentric?
Oh, no, there were some people, sure.
Okay, so what happened, what we discovered, and this is, I think, the problem that comes up, is that we've discovered that in our universe alone, there's hundreds of billions of stars, and who knows how many planets around those stars, and then there's hundreds of billions of those galaxies. So there's hundreds of billions of galaxies with hundreds of billions of stars just in our universe, and there may be a multiverse. So looking at that perspective, is it...
You said maybe, though. You know, here's the thing, you know, from that perspective. It's almost like God's sense of humor, but it's more practical than that. He started out with Satan and the angels and the demons, and they rebelled, and that didn't work out. So God says, okay, well, I'm going to put them on this little tiny ball where they can't get off of it, and let them work it out. And that's so they can't.
And you don't think God was all-knowing? He didn't know what was going to happen?
No.
He had to do this as an experiment?
Yeah, exactly.
He doesn't know the future?
No.
Okay, I mean, that's
if he knew the future, that means we don't have free will.
Okay, and that's non-traditional. I mean, most Christians
say
that. So we only have time for, like, one more theme. So do you want to continue on? You guys have a new line of questioning over here. Do you want to...